Uh-oh, fire! Fire! City Hall is burning! Don't worry, I'll put it out.
I look at you and I see a series. In fact, we would like to put cameras in your house and follow the human drama that is your family.
All right, then everyone will get to see me and my wacky antics.
It seems today that all you see is violence in movies and sex on TV.
But where are those good old-fashioned values
on which we used to rely?
And cry.
He's a family guy.
Armed with little more than a pencil and an outrageously twisted sense of humor, writer and animator Seth MacFarlane mined his New England roots to create an American family determined to put the fun back in dysfunctional.
You figure an average network pilot is maybe around $1 million. They gave me about 50,000.
Mom, are we on TV right now?
Yes, Chris. Your father signed a contract, and now we're going to be on TV for the next 6 months.
And so it meant 6 months of basically, you know, animating at home off of my kitchen counter. And I was an animation major in college, so I knew how to, you know, I knew how to animate.
It's partly an expression of my teenage angst, but mostly it's a moo cow.
It was always sort of important that, you know, the basic dynamic of family life be kept grounded so that the stuff that we did that was really outlandish, you know, we sort of earned that.
I thought we lived in such a nice small town.
There's no such thing anymore, Lois. Things are a lot different than when we were kids.
I mean, if Meg's at risk, then so is Chris. And Stewie will be in preschool before we know it.
Well, we just have to trust our kids to stay off drugs, is all.
I do trust our kids. It's the other kids I don't trust.
I guess it's up to us as parents to be a part of the solution. I'll go talk to the principal tomorrow.
Thanks, honey. The safety word is banana.
I love you. I'm priceless.
Peter is really a combination of just all the fat, loudmouth, you know, New Englanders that I've known growing up.
This comic sucks. He couldn't make me laugh even if I was laughing my ass off, and he was making me do it.
The guys who speak before they think.
Brian, it's moments like this that make me sad. You're gonna die 50 years before I do.
And always say the wrong thing, but, you know, their intentions are good.
You know why I married you, Lois? It's not just the rack or the caboose. It's that big, sexy brain of yours.
Oh. A lot of what Lois became had a lot to do with the actress who played her, Alex Borstein.
I need some excitement.
What are you talking about? Your life is plenty exciting. For example, there you go. Good night.
She would sort of turn Lois into this lively, sprightly, crazy woman.
Excuse me, we were about to use that.
You snooze, you lose, lady.
You have two choices. Either my baby swings from this jungle gym, or you do.
Ooh, Lois. Someone's wearing their ovaries on the outside.
She is the most sane of the bunch, probably. But when she lets loose, she really lets loose.
Lois! 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 Lois!
Meg!
Lois,
Meg,
Lois,
Meg,
Lois,
Meg,
Meg,
Meg!
Meg! Meg! Meg! Meg! Meg! Meg! Meg! Meg! Meg! Meg! Meg! Meg!
Atta girl! Shake your money maker!
Meg! 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 Meg!
Meg! Meg is the adolescent that we all knew or were in high school.
All right, what's going on back here? Oh, hello, Megan. Wait a minute. You're not part of the popular clique. You run along and play alone somewhere. Shame on you all, getting her hopes up like that.
She just doesn't fit in. She tries very hard, and her social graces leave a lot to be desired.
Hey, Meg! Ah, man, I love how these kids celebrate these days.
Their whole goal in life is just to be that popular kid and to fit in with the rest of the crowd. Can I help you?
Yeah, some company hired me to stand next to you all day so you'd look better by comparison.
That's ridiculous. I don't
need... Hey, Meg, did you get less ugly?
Yeah.
Chris is, it's interesting. Chris is, how the hell do you describe Chris?
When I stick this army guy with the sharp bayonet up my nose, it tickles my brain. Ow! Oh, now I don't know math.
Seth Green came in to audition, and he just, you know, killed us. I mean, we were just laughing our asses off.
This is one of those things that you read and you just wish, oh my gosh, let me get this part. Let me be involved in something this silly and creative and fun.
Hey, Meg, try and guess the word I'm thinking of right now. And it's not kitty.
Car.
No.
I don't know, apple?
No. Give up?
Yeah.
It was kitty!
Again, that's another example of a character that really evolved in such a way that really had a lot to do with his performance. And he would come into the booth and just basically improvise in Chris's voice.
Chris, you're hogging up all the fans.
Yeah, well, you're hogging up all the ugly.
Brian is he'd rather, in a lot of ways, rather not be there. He'd rather be with a family that's, you know, more intelligent and stimulates him mentally.
Okay, let's go over the commands. Shit. Good. Roll over.
Peter, I'm already schwitzing like crazy here. Let's call it a night, huh?
So he turns to the booze. He's an alcoholic. He drinks some martinis. He drinks the scotch.
I think you've had about enough.
Well, I think you're wrong, you increasingly attractive-looking woman. You know, you're really pretty.
Oh, stop.
No, I'm serious. You could be in magazines. You could. You can, and not just like jugs or creamsicle. Call me. She won't call.
He's just much too intelligent to be a domesticated animal, so he's constantly sort of searching for what his purpose is.
Maybe this isn't where I thought I was going to be at 7 years old. It's just that is it okay if I smoke in here?
Stewie is the little Napoleonic guy who's just can't stand the fact that he doesn't have any control over anything.
I say, am I to spend the entire day wallowing around in my own feces? A little service here.
His limbs are too short to accomplish anything. He needs people to, carry him around and do stuff for him.
Victory is mine. Oh! No, 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 you imbecile. That's not talc. That's paprika. Oh! Take that.
It's developed within him just a hatred of the world and of Lois in particular, who he sees as sort of his jailkeeper.
Don't even get me started. I mean, really, when I think of the times that woman has... Oh, I won't even begin to... There's always been a lot of tension between Lois and me. Excellent. The mind control device is nearing completion.
Stewie, I said no toys at the table.
Damn you, vile woman! You've impeded my work since the day I escaped from your wretched womb. It's not so much that I want to kill her.
Bye-bye, Stewie. Mommy will be upstairs to kiss you goodnight.
Burn in hell! It's just, I want her not to be alive anymore. Bend down, Mother.
Yes, honey?
He's out to control the world.
Well, hey there, little boy. Are you lost?
Now listen to me, Jolene. I've got an army to raise, and I must get to Nicaragua. I require a window seat and an in-flight Happy Meal.
As the episodes progress, we sort of see that there's much more under the surface than just this, Bond villain.
Damn you! You're one of them, aren't you? What are they paying you? I'll double it. I'll give you whatever you want. Money, women, men.
We delved a lot more into, the other aspects of Stewie's personality, which is the closet homosexual thing.
I'm the greatest captain of the Queen's Navy.
And your record will stand as proof.
Be it galley or a freighter, I'm an expert navigator.
And you're also a world-class poof.
We did an episode that didn't actually air, that where Stewie realizes, says, oh my God, I'm gay.
My maniqui defeat is mistaken on the street for a sailor who can pirouette on cue. Well, despite your point of view, I can thrill a girl or two. But I'd rather get it on with you.
Wow, the evidence is really piling up.
Make any joke you want. You know I look good.
You're drunk again.
Oh, God, what am I doing?
All the coat and civilian.
Stinger with a whiskey bag.
Let's do it!
Freaking
believable.
I spent some time in Rhode Island, and what he has basically is, it's just a Rhode Island accent.
Lois, everyone has their sanctuary. The Catholics have churches, fat people have Wisconsin, and I have the Pawtucket Brewery.
He sort of came from, there was a security guard where I went to college who had a very, very thick Rhode Island accent, and I just used to shit myself listening to this guy talk.
She said a swear.
Everything he said was just, unintentionally funny.
Women are not people. They are devices built by the Lord Jesus Christ for our entertainment.
Do you even listen to yourself when you talk?
I drift in and out.
Brian, I also do.
Well, Peter, you've only got a couple of hours left. If you're going to pull a party out of your ass, you might want to stand up.
Basically, my regular voice. I'm not changing much.
I just need some time to think, all right?
Yes, yes, you've got lots to think about, haven't you? Public drunkenness, grand theft auto.
You left out the part where I made you smash your head on the windshield.
Well, I don't recall. Yes, well, I suppose I walked right into that one.
Stewie is, I'm a huge Rex Harrison fan. I love, you know, his Henry Higgins, My Fair Lady, and that's really where Stewie comes from.
Once again, here is how it should sound. How do you do? And here's how you sound.
If you watch him in that movie, you can hear Stewie. I mean, it's a you draggle-tailed, blunt-edged gutter snipe.
Leonard, you pudgy-faced Applejohn!
Why, you tottering, fen-sucked dewberry! You want it bad, and you don't care who you get it from because you have no self-respect, and that gets you off, doesn't it?
Huh? McFarlane is the first to admit, however, that he couldn't do it all alone, so he surrounded himself with a chorus of comedic talent.
We have this unbelievable cast. Seth Green, multi-talented guy. I mean, he, just hugely talented. He's so enthusiastic about the show.
It's so fun because what Chris started out as is so different from what he became. They just made him so weird and confused and hopelessly awkward.
All right, son, I'm gonna need those two hams back.
I don't have any hams.
Lift up your shirt, son.
I need an adult!
You're not a shoplifter. You're just a fat kid.
He's big boned and sweats a lot and just can't measure depth perception very well.
Now you.
And not incredibly intelligent.
Whoever comes up with the best idea for the big Christmas toy this year gets a huge bonus.
Hey, Dad, why don't you invent the Frisbee? That's an awesome toy.
It's already been invented.
Then how come I never heard of it?
But very spirited and often comes up with bizarrely astute observations.
This kind of acrimony isn't gonna resolve our differences.
Just shut up and throw a chair.
Okay.
Mila Kunis, who's on That 70s Show, made Meg a very believable character.
I just want to kill myself. I'm going upstairs right now and eat a whole bowl of peanuts. I'm allergic to peanuts. You don't know anything about me.
What was that guy?
Meg's such a poor little kid. I feel so sorry for her. She's trying so hard to fit in, but she's just so not popular.
Mom, you were right. I was nice to the cool kids, and they didn't spit on me.
She wears the condom hat. She just needs to change her wardrobe.
Oh, how wonderful. Now, what time do we nail those snot-nosed punks?
Alex Borstein's Lois.
Lois sounds a little bit like this, and she is kind of the cornerstone of the family.
Boys, please, it's Christmas Eve. This is a night for magic and wonder and joy. Okay, so a couple of things have gone wrong, but we can still have a great Christmas.
But I kept kind of playing around and giving her a little bit more spunk.
Meg, honey, get me some paper towels.
She did become a red-haired, brazen lunatic of a woman.
We're out of paper towels.
No. Paper towels!
Yeah! Oh, here's the paper towels.
Probably 70% of the female voices that you hear on the show are Alex.
Hurricane Norman is beginning to pound Quahog. We now go live to Asian reporter
Trisha Takanawa. Diane, I'm hearing.
She's unbelievably talented and unbelievably versatile.
God, you're dumb. Thank God for that ass. Now come here and kiss me.
Patrick Warburton, who does the voice of Joe, is fantastic. Mike Henry, who does Cleveland. We had Jennifer Love Hewitt. We had all of Kiss, the band, Dick Van Patten, the whole cast of Murphy Brown, Tony Danza. I worked with Adam West when I was at Hanna-Barbera and was desperate to have him involved with Family Guy somehow. He's a very funny guy.
I love this job more than I love taffy. And I'm a man who enjoys his taffy. Mmm.
Patrick Duffy and Victoria Principal did a live action reprisal of their famous end cliffhanger scene from Dallas.
I dreamt I saw the strangest episode of Family Guy, and there was a giant chicken, and Stewie was an octopus.
Hey, come on now. It's all right, everything's gonna be okay. What's Family Guy?
In an attempt to keep their beloved Griffins on the air, the show's rabid fans went to great and creative lengths to show their support.
Hey, Lois, you see my pants? Boy, will I be glad when that studio audience moves out of the neighborhood.
There was this huge push. You know, they sent baby food, they sent diapers, you know, for Stewie to the network. And according to the network, it's the biggest fan push that they've seen in their history.
Oh, dear, there are so many people to thank. God, of course. And, who else? Oh, this is so unexpected. Oh, yes, Satan.
There was a letter-writing campaign. There was an internet petition with over 100,000 signatures. I have to applaud the Fox censors. They're wonderful, wonderful people.
I'm looking for toilet training books.
Oh, yes, we can help you there. Everybody poops is still the standard, of course. We've also got the less popular Nobody Poops But You.
Huh. Well, see, we're Catholic, so,
Oh, then you want You're a Naughty Child, and that's concentrated evil coming out the back of you.
Perfect!
For the most part, they knew what the show was. They knew it was an on-the-edge sort of show, and there was never really a major attempt to fix that.
Can I get you beer, Peter?
What do you got?
I've got Bush. Oh, and Bush Light.
Don't forget our deal, Lois. I sit through this, and later tonight, I get anal. You hear me? No matter how neat I want the house, you have to clean it. So you're saying I need a Jewish guy to handle my money?
Peter, not every Jewish person is good with money.
Well, yeah, I guess not the retarded ones, but why would you even say that? For shock value? Jeez, Cleveland, it's edgy and it's offensive.
So you guys aren't offended by this?
This family's probably as bizarre as any family can get, with a talking little baby and a talking dog.
This is the kind of mind-numbing schlock that's turning our society into a cultural wasteland.
I loved how quick it was, and how fast it was, and how disturbing Seth MacFarlane's sense of humor is.
Shame on the network that put this junk on the air.
Man, I'm so proud of this. I'm just so proud to have been involved in something this outrageous.
How can you stand watching this? It's dreck and you know it. Oh, don't have the guts to respond, huh? No intelligent defense of this unmitigated crap?
Commercial!
Probably the single most commonly asked question is, when is Family Guy coming out on DVD? You know, where can I get, you know, the episodes, and are they releasing it? And, you know, it's great for me because I won't have people saying to me anymore, can you get me VHS copies of every episode, like all 50 of them?
You must beshrew me.